You are listening to bangradio.net.
A couple has had infidelity or any of those things. Let's say there's been problems where you're just not matching up. What is your goal like when you're trying to connect people back up in relationships? In fact, answer that, and then I have another question for you that came from one of the guys in my group.
Sure. Well, infidelity is actually, I think I can comfortably say it's my favorite thing to work on mm-hmm. because it's the easiest. And a lot of people are surprised by that. They think it'd be a very difficult thing to work through. But the thing is that your mind creates stories more so than it perceives reality. So with cheating, right. it's more about perception than anything. And so it's about addressing, okay, so what do you think this means? What does it mean to you? Do you think that it has some effect on whether or not they love you? Do you think that it means you're a shitty person or maybe unworthy? And you go through all this kind of stuff and you figure out all the different ways it's affecting them. And then you show them a much clearer picture. The comparison I like to use is that most people, when their partner cheats on them, it's like a cop who thinks he sees a gun and just fucking blasts a dude into oblivion. You know, they just go nuts when their partner cheats on them. But then my job is to show them that it's not a gun. It's just like some random, like I don't know, like a fucking TV remote or whatever, a harmless object. Cheating has almost nothing to do, usually has absolutely nothing to do with the person being cheated on. It's totally a reflection of the person who's done the cheating. And so it's a lot about working that out. And in terms of like connecting people, maybe there's not necessarily something bad happening. The first thing I ask them is, you know, where are you at? Why are you here? And do you even want to be connected? A big misconception is that you're going to go to therapy and you're going to get like tons of advice and I'm going to tell you what to do. But the thing is, I don't know shit about the people who are sitting in front of me. Even if I've been seeing them for weeks, an hour a week, that gives me like, 10 hours of experience with that person based totally off of their subjective reality they're communicating to me versus them who's they've been themselves their whole life. They know so much more about their inner psyche than I do. So my job is to act kind of like a tour guide. I just take them through their own mind and help them explore things, figure out what's the best option for them, why these things have happened. We look at motives, we look at beliefs, conceptions, and then the behaviors that are actually affecting the relationship. So my goal, first of all, is to create kind of like a map of where they're at, how they got there, and figure out all their kind of internal psychological structure, and then manipulate that in ways that will give them the results that they're looking to achieve in their relationship.
And so if the cheating has to do with the person who's actually doing it, you really work on them, but how do you heal the person who's, you know, been hurt by it? Or I suppose they're both, you know, jaded by it.
Yeah, both are hurt. I just read a really good article today about how a guy, you know, he thought he had the perfect partner in his affair partner, and they both agreed to leave their, you know, one husband respectively, and they did, and then 7 months into this relationship with his affair partner, the same stuff happened that happened with his wife, and I was like, yo, big fucking surprise there, buddy.
Right,
like,
totally, yeah.
What are you thinking?
Yeah.
And the big thing is, like, with people who cheat, the damage is the perception that there's problems in their relationship and the solution is to look outwards rather than facing their own flaws and dealing with it and accepting that their expectations are maybe out of line. That's a really common one with cheaters, is they have a perception that their relationship is so far below average because they have a really fucked up view of what average is. And you mentioned that before, that happiness is based more off of where you think you are and compared to the norm rather than, you know, how does it make you feel and how good is it for you. And it's very true for the people that have been cheated on. It's all about convincing them that it isn't a reflection on them. That's it.
Yeah, but man, the degree, maybe I'm just crazier than most, or the women I've been with are crazy the most. I don't know what it is, but here's the deal. Like, so when I've been cheated on, or when I've cheated on somebody, or when I've had relationships that are open and then we just couldn't handle it, man, so many different variations. Like, what has happened to me, what motivated me to want to have sex with other people? First off, I wanted to. It wasn't necessarily that there was wrong.
That's it. They just wanted to do it. Yeah. That's the thing. It's not some fucking weird, totally complex thing. People who cheat just want to cheat.
Yeah, and it like the concept, we were talking about addiction earlier before this, but the concept of cheating wasn't, it wasn't like I'm trying to hurt my girlfriend. I'm trying
to
hurt
exactly.
Her. Had nothing, that wasn't even in my mind.
Yeah,
it was that, fuck, I want to fuck this chick's
hot. I want to slam this chick, yeah.
In all sorts of variations of different ways. And then that happens. And I think where shit gets really fucked up, really in, I could talk about a lot of different situations, but where shit gets really fucked up in that situation when you're in a relationship is that, oh man, there's just so many levels to this. But when we try and make it function after that, because I have sex with somebody else, I don't know how to communicate to my partner. I don't know how to communicate to that other person. I like it. You know, it's impossible. This is something that we do not get. Like I can love the girl that I'm with. And then if I'm having sex with another girl, yeah, I can think about whatever I want about her, but as soon as I'm having sex with her, I start to develop an emotional map of some sort with her.
Yeah,
that I didn't expect. And yeah, man, and it happens, and you're like, you feel this draw towards them, you feel this draw towards this other woman, you feel like all this sort of stuff, and you don't know how to be open and honest about it.
Common problem.
You can't be honest with yourself, you know.
Good point.
It's just so nuts where we get into it. And then we start ending up as this guy going, hey, I'm going to leave my wife for you. You're going to leave your husband for me. Then we get together and we haven't sorted out the deeper shit in there of in the deeper shit to me. So my journey in this and the stuff that I like really looked for myself in it was not, how do I love my wife better? How do I love my girlfriend better? Or something like that. It was like, why do I have this need? Why do I have this thing that when I feel something, I can't articulate it, so I can only act and react? And that, I think that is actually the root of addiction. That's the root of compulsion and obsession, because I can't go, I just want to fuck that.